Your great error, my dear friend, is to consider life, reality, as a limitation.
But isn't that what it is? Reality only distracts and degrades us.
You know, sometimes I think that artists are rather like hunters aiming in the dark. They don't know what their target is, and they don't know if they've hit it. But you can't expect life to illuminate the target and steady your aim. The creation of beauty and purity is a spiritual act.
No, Gustav. No! Beauty belongs to the senses. Only to the senses.
You cannot reach the spirit. You cannot reach the spirit through the senses. You cannot. It's only by complete domination of the senses that you can ever achieve wisdom, truth, and human dignity.
Wisdom, human dignity?
Yes.
What use are they? Genius is a divine gift.
No.
A divine affliction. A sinful, morbid flashfire of natural gifts.
I reject the demonic virtues of art.
And you are wrong. Evil is a necessity. It is the food of genius.
The tea is served.
Thank you, sir. Do you want some tea? Please. If you want milk, help yourself to it.
Okay.
You know, Alfred, art is the highest source of education. And the artist has to be exemplary. He must be a model of balance and strength. He cannot be ambiguous.
But art is ambiguous.
And music, the most ambiguous of all the arts.
It is ambiguity made a science.
Wait.
Listen to this chord. Or this one. You can interpret them in any way you like. You have before you an entire series of mathematical combinations, unforeseen and inexhaustible. A paradise of double meanings in which you, more than anyone else, romp and roll about like a calf in clover.
Stop!
It's yours!
Stop. It's all yours!